Very good. So let's get started. I'm Pete Novak and country manager for US and Canada at Cambridge Assessment English, and we'll be your host today. Today's webinar is going to be focusing on studying in the US. We are proud to be partnering with Michigan Language Assessment. So welcome, Julie. And joined by Broward College and Bunker Hill Community College to deliver today's webinar, which will provide valuable information on the many advantages of the community college route to U.S. higher education and how we can help you achieve this next step in your journey. There will also be a chance at the end of the webinar to ask your questions. So before we start, please listen to the following suggestions to enjoy this session. First, please close all other programs if you can. This will help with the connection. We're all working from home, and so sometimes there may be a delay. Don't worry. If that happens, please just bear with us. This event is live, and it will be recorded and shared afterwards with you. During the webinar, you will be able to use the chat box right at the top for any comments and the separate Q&A box for any questions for our presenters. If we know the answer, our moderators will type an answer to you straight away. Also, our presenters will then answer as many questions as they can at the end. So don't worry if your questions are not answered right away. By way of introductions, you're likely familiar with Cambridge Assessment English, since many of you have already taken or are perhaps preparing for one of our Cambridge English exams. For those who are not familiar with Cambridge Assessment English, we are part of Cambridge Assessment, a department of the University of Cambridge. For well over 100 years, we have been producing a variety of global standard exams and supporting the communities of primary, secondary, and higher education teachers and learners. Our mission is educational, to help people to learn English and prove their skills to the world. For us, learning English is more than just exams and grades. It's about having the confidence to communicate and access a lifetime of enriching experiences and opportunities. Our qualifications are based on research into effective teaching and learning. They motivate people of all ages and abilities to learn English and develop practical skills for the real world. Each exam focuses on a level of the Common European Framework of Reference, or CFR, helping learners to improve their speaking, writing, reading, and listening skills step by step. Whatever your goals or ambitions, Cambridge English qualifications and exams are a mark of excellence accepted and trusted by more than 25,000 universities, employers, and government departments all over the world for admissions, recruitment, graduation, and a whole host of other purposes. For this reason, more than 5.5 million people take our qualifications and tests every year. We have a network of over 2,800 centers in 130 countries, as well as more than 50,000 preparation centers helping you learn and take your exam. This webinar today is not focusing on English proficiency exams, yet participants often ask us about the requirements for studying in the US. I'm happy to say that you can apply across the United States with, in many cases, B2 first and certainly C1 advanced and C2 proficiency. That includes the colleges presenting today. Although keep in mind that each institution and program, programs within the institutions may have different requirements. So we always recommend to take a look at each institution's website for details. You can visit our global recognition database shown on the slide to see who else accepts your results, or visit our website to learn more about taking the exams if you don't already have yours yet. If you do, you can use our online results verification service to securely share your results with your chosen institution as part of the application. We are delighted to have with us today Julie Montero de Castro from Michigan Language Assessment, Ella Kiyovska from Bunker Hill Community College, and Stephen Mitchell from Broward College. First, we will hear from Julie from Michigan Language Assessment. We will then have an introduction to community colleges from Ella and Stephen. Then we will hear more about Broward and Bunker Hill before ending our session with a Q&A. So with that, welcome and over to you, Julie.
Thank you so much, Pete. And it's so nice to welcome all of our students from around the world. Thank you for joining in the webinar today. As Pete mentioned, Michigan Language Assessment is a joint venture, nonprofit collaboration between the University of Michigan and Cambridge Assessment English. And our objective is to help individuals achieve their educational and career goals by providing trusted English language exams. Our story began in 1941 when the University of Michigan established the English Language Institute, the first university-based intensive English language program in the United States, and the first language research and teaching program of its kind in the Western Hemisphere. In 2010, we formed our joint venture with Cambridge Assessment English, and today higher education institutions, government agencies, and employers around the world rely on our English language tests to assess the and verify the proficiency of English language learners such as yourselves of all ages and levels. The Michigan tests enable students worldwide to expand their personal opportunities and gain internationally recognized certification. And we are proud to help learners to achieve their goals. The Michigan tests for higher education include a variety of exams, very similarly to Cambridge Assessment English that Pete has mentioned. We have our ECCE and ECPE, which many of our language learners, particularly in Europe and Latin America, are familiar with, as well as the MET, which is a multi-level exam. And these exams are accepted, as Pete had mentioned, from B1 all the way up through C2 proficiency in English. So you're welcome to utilize those credentials at many institutions, including Broward and Bunker Hill. And we are very pleased to announce the upcoming digital launch of MET, which will come in October, starting this October. You'll be able to utilize an at-home option or in-center option at our authorized testing centers throughout the 30 countries, or our new Prometric partnership, which will enable testing all over the world. So if you haven't taken an exam already, that might be an option to consider starting in October. And with that, I'm going to hand it over to Stephen and Ella to discuss how to apply and come through community colleges in the United States, as well as specific information about both Broward and Bunker Hill.
Thank you, Julie and Pete. So my name is Stephen Mitchell. I am the international recruiter for Broward College here in sunny South Florida, just north of Miami. Good afternoon, good evening, or good morning, depending on where in the world you are watching this today, both live or on the recording. I'm going to give you a brief overview of education in the United States. So a bachelor's degree is typically 4 years, and the first 2 years are almost always the same no matter what school you attend. So you're taking your general education courses, math, English, science, et cetera, and then the beginning courses of your major. Now, community colleges were started over 100 years ago for various reasons so that education could be accessible to more people. And community colleges then partnered with universities to do those first 2 years of your general education courses. So under the 2+2 plan, you're doing those general education courses and the beginning courses of your major to receive what's called an associate degree. And that allows you to then transfer to a university to complete the last 2 years of your bachelor's degree. Next slide, Pete. So you can see it looks like this. So year number one and two are exactly the same, whether you're doing them at university or whether you're doing them at a community college. The difference is, of course, that when you're doing those first 2 years at a community college, you're usually saving a substantial amount of money because the tuition at community colleges are usually quite less. And so you're able to save a lot of money and yet you take the same courses and many times even the same professors, as sometimes professors go back and forth and teach between both university and community colleges. Then at the end of those 2 years, you would transfer to university to complete the last 2 years. And you're getting the same exact degree as you would if you went to university for all 4 years. Next slide. Ella?
Let us talk. Good morning, good afternoon, and hello world. This is Ella from the Bunker Hill Community College in Boston. I will talk briefly about advantages of joining community college. I often refer to our types of institution as the best hidden secret in the higher education in the United States. Concept of a community college is not very well known, I think, outside of United States, but there are many advantages of starting your program, your education at the community college. One of them is we really are open to everyone who wants to study. So the entrance requirement, the access is much lower, and we try to remove possible barriers to anyone who would like to join us. We don't have competitive requirements. We don't ask for specific GPA, and we don't ask for standardized tests like SAT, ACT. We don't ask for recommendation letter. It's really simple and easy to gain admission to a community college. Many of our institutions, we have on campus our own intensive English program. We call it ESL. So for many of you, if you are already, you know, studying English outside of United States, you can take Cambridge or Michigan test and submit this course for admission requirements. It is easy transition to from the intensive English program on our campuses to an associate degree. And as Stephen mentioned already, the cost of tuition is lower if you start attending community college. You can save thousands of dollars, and both of us have examples how significant these savings can be. Let's go to the next slide, Stephen.
Yeah, community college, another advantage is that it's a great transition from high school to higher education. The classes at community colleges are usually much smaller. You're usually looking at anywhere from 20 to 25 students per class, whereas many times in university, you'll have 100 students or more. And so you're really getting a lot of personalized attention from your professors as well as the administrators. As I mentioned earlier, some of the professors you get are going to be the same as the ones you would get at university, yet you're paying less tuition. So not only do community colleges have their standard professors that are full-time, but they also have what are called adjunct professors. So these professors teach at other schools and then come over to the community college to teach. The other great aspect of adjunct professors is that many of them are actually still working in their field. Yes. So when you're taking an engineer class or a business class, you're being taught by someone who's still working as an engineer or still working in the business field. So you're getting some great real-world experience. You can also get an extra year of OPT. OPT is called optional practical training. You're allowed to work under your F1 visa when you come to the United States as an international student for 1 year after obtaining a degree in your field. So if you are an engineer major, you get to work in the engineering field for 1 year under your F1 visa before returning to your country. When you go to university, you go all 4 years, get your bachelor's degree, and you get 1 year of OPT. When you do the 2+2 method, because you're getting an actual degree, the Associate of Arts degree usually, then you're actually able to do a year of OPT after you get your associate's degree, then transfer to university, complete your bachelor's degree with those final 2 years, and then get another year of OPT. So now you would get 2 years of OPT by doing the 2+2 method as opposed to going straight to university. And the other aspect of community college is that there are many students out there who don't necessarily want a bachelor's degree. They're really more interested in a career. And this is where community colleges also are a great benefit. They have many two-year programs that are called technical degrees by some institutions that allow you to go directly into the workforce. So you're taking less of the general education courses and then jumping directly into your major. So whether it's nursing, whether it's graphic arts, whether it's accounting, these are two-year programs where you jump right into the program. And at the end of that program, you're eligible for a year of OPT, and then to go right into the workplace.
It is another advantage of being at the community college is that many of our institutions have negotiated with four-year school a very smooth transition for everyone who graduates with a degree from a community college to move on and pursue the bachelor degree. And it's often automatic based on negotiated contract. As graduates of a community college, you are very competitive, and colleges and universities, four-year institutions, will come to our campuses to really advertise their programs, offer their services, and hoping that you will join their campuses. Many of us are working tirelessly and keep updating agreements and negotiate the best condition for our students to transfer to a four-year institution. So all credits that you take on our campus will be counting towards your degree requirement at the next school. What is also often what has happened is that these articulation agreements, when you go to a four-year school after completing a degree at a community college, bring with them a substantial scholarship and also discounted tuition rates in some cases. And also what we want you to know, sometimes it's hard, you know, right after you finish high school to secure admission to a competitive Ivy League school. There is another way around, and this would be via community college. You can come, you can join one of our programs and prove yourself, prove your academic strength, earn excellent grades, get practical experience. This all makes you a competitive candidate that Ivy League institutions then will consider, and hopefully you will join their ranks. Next.
So this time, Bunker Hill and Broward College are going to tell you a little bit about our schools. In particular, we've given you some general overviews about Broward, about community colleges, and now we're going to talk specifically about our schools. So Broward College, again, is in South Florida, just north of Miami. Fort Lauderdale is the big city in Broward County. We've been around since 1960. We've celebrated just our 60th anniversary last year. We were the first institution of higher education in the county, and we still are the largest institution of higher education in Broward. We are also highly ranked. So we have received the Aspen Institutes of top 10 community colleges in the country 4 times. And in fact, this past year, we were a finalist with distinction, which ranked us as one of the top 3 community colleges in the country. We are very affordable. Our tuition is only $4,500 per term. With books, about $500 for books. So it's about $5,000 per term for tuition and books. We have over 63,000 students from 150 different countries. Pre-pandemic, we had about 700 students studying under the F1 visa program, down to about 500 now, but we have a lot of students who are waiting to come back in as soon as the borders are clear. And so we expect to get back up to that 700 number very quickly. We have over 140 different programs. These are divided out into 8 different pathway programs. So no matter whether you're interested in STEM, science, technology, engineering, or math, business, health sciences, social, the arts, we have the program for you. And of course, we have lots of different student advantages. Again, we have the adjunct professors, our full-time professors, library services. We have libraries on all 3 of our campuses. You go to the next slide. Free academic advising, free tutoring. We have campus libraries on all 3 of our campuses, plus the online database. Outreach services to help you with any transition you may have from moving to the United States, as well as any support that you need for equipment, things of that nature. Our career center will help you with your resume and for looking for a job when you're ready to do OPT. And we also have what's called an Honors College program. Many of our international students take advantage of our Honors College program. You can get into the Honors College after your first term with a 3.5 GPA, which is basically a B+, A- average. And all of our Honors College graduates get accepted to the transfer school of their choice, and all of them are getting scholarships to do that. In fact, a few years ago, we had an international student who was an Honors College graduate who got accepted to Brown University, Ivy League school, like Ella was mentioning, and got a full scholarship to attend that school. Next slide. But of course, at Broward College, we don't want you to just be a bookworm and to study all the time and hang out in the library. We want you to have a vibrant college life as well. And so we do have an active student life at all of our campuses. We have 3 campuses around Broward County. And so whether it's student government, our student ambassador program, various clubs and organizations, performing arts, intramural athletics, and fitness centers, there's always something to do on all of our campuses. Next slide. We do not have housing at Broward College, but we do have a housing partner near our central campus. It's also very close to our south campus, which also houses the Perry Airport. So if you're interested in aviation, we do have a pilot program, an aviation mechanics program, and an air traffic control program. So the housing can be close to that program as well. Next slide. So at Broward College, one of the things we like to say is that you're going to start here, you're going to finish somewhere else, whether it's going directly into a job after a technical degree or the 2+2 program going to a university, and you're going to be able to succeed anywhere you want. Next slide. And we have different ways for you to do that. So whether it's starting off in our English for Academic Purposes program, EAP, our Associate of Science, our Associate of Arts, or our Bachelor's program, we do have a few bachelor's programs, as well as certificates. We have certainly a program that can assist you with your educational needs. Next one. I want to talk first about our English for Academic Purposes program. Now, this program is not a typical ESL program in that you must know some English in order to be admitted to this program. So this is where your Cambridge or Michigan assessment would come into play to see if you qualify for this program. It's not designed to teach you English. It's designed to help you improve your English and to become a student, learn how to be a student in English. So teaching you how to write papers in English, give presentations in English, et cetera, and learn how to be a student in English. That's okay, you can go. Many students do use this program as well. For if you already have a bachelor's degree in your home country and you're trying to get into a graduate school, but your English is not good enough, you can use that EAP program for that. The next program is the technical degree program, the Associate of Science degrees. The two-year program is designed to prepare you for media employment in a specialized career field such as health sciences. We have nursing, radiography, sonography, dental assisting, dental hygiene, et cetera. Some of those programs will transfer to a bachelor's degree, but the majority of them do not. Next one. And then the main program that we've been talking about today, which is the 2+2 program. Again, this is the one where you're going to be taking your general education courses plus the beginning classes of your major. And once you get your Associate of Arts degree, you're eligible to transfer to university. Don't let the name Associate of Arts fool you. Even if you are a science major, chemistry, physics, or a STEM major, engineering, science, technology, you're still being the Associate of Arts degree because that's the program that transfers to university. Next slide. So these are some of the schools in which you can transfer once you've received a degree from Broward College. So whether it's any of the Florida State schools, public universities like University of Florida, Florida State University, Arizona State University, we also have articulation agreements with over 20 universities around the United States, Arizona State, University of Kentucky, University of Cincinnati, et cetera. This is just an example of some of the schools you can transfer to. And as you can see, many of them are highly ranked. The other thing about transfer is, as Ella mentioned, the articulation agreements mean that all of your credits transfer. So when you go into these schools, you go in as a third year student, they take all of your credits when you get to transfer to these schools. Next slide. This is just an example of the types of savings when you do the 2+2 method when you're coming from Broward College. So for example, Florida International University, which is in Miami, if you go there as an international student, you're paying about $76,000 for all 4 years. But if you do your first 2 years at Broward College and then transfer to FIU, you're saving yourself about $16,000. And of course, you could save even more because, as was mentioned, many of our students are getting transfer scholarships to attend those schools. Mm-hmm. Next slide. And then, of course, many students apply to private schools as well. So as you can see, Harvard University, University of Miami, it's about the same. If you were to go directly to those schools, those are private universities, you're spending over $200,000 for all 4 years. But if you were to go to Broward College first and then transfer, you're saving about $80,000 on your tuition, plus hopefully even more when you're getting scholarships to go to those schools. Mm-hmm. Next slide. And then finally, we do have some bachelor's programs. You do have to have 60 qualifying college credits or already have a bachelor's degree in order to get into our bachelor's programs. So we have aerospace sciences, environmental science, supervision and management. Our nursing program is designed for our nursing graduates, education, information technology, supply chain management, which of course is big now, especially after the pandemic, and technology management. Next one. So that's pretty much it for Broward College. We welcome to answer any questions you have at the end of both presentations. This is our email, which will be repeated at the end. And also our website is broward.edu/ISSO. It takes you directly to the International Student Services Office webpage that tells you how to become an international student with the F1 visa program. Ellen.
Yes, great. Welcome everyone. So this is a view that we all who are working at Bunker Hill and our students are missing our campus, the main entrance, Bunker Hill Community College in Boston. Let's go to the next slide. We are located on the East Coast of the United States, and many of you did hear about Boston. We are about 5 hours by car from New York, if the traffic is not bad, and 8 hours drive or 1 hour on the plane from Washington, D.C. Next slide. When you look at the neighborhood of how Bunker Hill is located, I marked it with a red arrow where our campus is located. I want you to know that our neighborhood and our neighbors are fantastic. There are over 40 universities and colleges in Boston, metropolitan Boston, and in the state of Massachusetts, we have about over 100 colleges and universities. We are laughing sometimes that, you know, MIT is just across the bridge, so you cross the highway and you can be at the MIT campus. It's close to Harvard, Boston University. For many of our students, it is a very convenient place to study. You start at Bunker Hill Community College, you transfer to the next institution, and you never have to relocate and leave Boston. You can complete all of your education and get your practical experience right here. Let's go next. What do we offer? Many choices. The slide on the right has been already explained. Where do community colleges fit in the first year of your undergraduate degree? At Bunker Hill, similarly to Broward College, we offer associate degree in arts, in sciences, and also much shorter in duration certificate programs. We have over 100 programs available to you. So I think we have option for everyone. We also recently opened our intensive English program. So for those of you who would like to come and study English as a second language, this is also a choice. You pick and we will assist you on your journey. Let's go to the next. What we also offer is affordable education. As Stephen mentioned, joining community college brings incredible savings. So for those of you who would like to, you know, live comfortably in a beautiful apartment while you have excellent education, community college is a choice. I put three numbers here for you. The first one, $10,000, it's approximate tuition and fees to join our college for 1 year. This is about $10,000. Next number, 17, applies to regional university where you can transfer. So you can either join them after you complete Bunker Hill Community College or start there, but you would pay $7,000 more. And competitive, a private institution here in Boston where you pay $58,000 just for tuition and fees for 1 year. Imagine 4 years of debt. This joining community college can really, really provide you with huge savings and have access to excellent education. Many of our professors are Bunker Hill professors. Many adjuncts teach at Harvard, MIT, Northeastern University. So you have access to the best instructors that you can get in the US. Next one. We talked about creating the path. The picture on the right should show you how safe and how secure your path will be after joining community college. There is a straight road to the four-year institution. You don't have to worry almost about anything. Just think about where will you go. And where do our students transfer, our Bunker Hill students? Everywhere. We have students who did transfer to Columbia University, to MIT, to Harvard, to Georgia Tech. Many of our students decide to stay locally in Boston because of the convenience. You can transfer to one of five campuses of UMass Boston, and you can pick many of the private institutions that are available to you. We have transfer agreements with over 20 universities that we have negotiated for you, and we have created over 100 pathways and master transfer programs that you can choose from. If you are taking advantage of these agreements, the benefits that are available to you are guaranteed admission to certain programs, guaranteed transfer of your credits to particular programs, reduced tuition, and additional scholarships that are given to students who are transferring specifically from community colleges. So this is a fantastic advantage that I hope many of you would take advantage of. Next. What do we offer outside of the classroom? I always refer kind of looking at what experiences our students are looking for. Bunker Hill offers you the experience of a large institution, a less residential campus. We don't have dormitories, and our campus, it's smaller when it comes to the size. We have about 15,000 students who are enrolled at Bunker Hill Community College. So we are smaller than Broward, but this makes us, you know, even though 15,000 students is not a small campus, but many students feel welcome and feel at home right from the first moment when you come and visit us. So we have fantastic opportunities for students. We have very dynamic career services office that is looking and securing internship opportunities for our students. We offer merit scholarships. We also have honors program available to our students. For those of you who are creative, who are writers, artists, who the design staff, you can submit your work to Tell Magazine and it will be published and distributed to students and alumni. We have opportunity for you to be engaged in over 30 plus student group on organizations. Our outgoing president of Student Government Association is going to Columbia University and he was an international student. We just, you know, said goodbye to him. You have access to performing arts on our campus and take advantage at no cost to academic and personal support services. Like Broward, you can have a tutor, you can have a help in a writing center with your math. Anything that you would need support with, we have it for our students. So you will be very well supported on every step of your journey here on our campus. Next. And the, you know, desired OPT. This is also, of course, an opportunity that you can get at an associate degree level, either after you complete your certificate program or an associate degree. So I just try to illustrate here that it is not an opportunity given to you once while you are a student in the United States. It's available to you after every degree level. So you go from associate to bachelor to master to PhD level. And as far as long as you go to the next and higher educational level, you become eligible for new OPT time. And what is also what you should maybe remember for students who are in the STEM, so science, technology, engineering, and math program, once you go on and complete bachelor degree, you can have additional 24 months of OPT. So these are great options for students to really study hard, but then apply the knowledge that you have obtained in the classroom, in practice, and really be skilled and an expert in your field. And after your OPT ends, many of our students decide to transfer and pursue bachelor degree. And then you go to the next institution. Next. Our admission, as I said, we try to be accessible and make things easy for our students. You apply online. Our application is fully free. You don't mail any documents. All documents are accepted via scanned copies. We offer convenient three-start dates, so you can start at Bunker Hill in January, in June, or in September. And what we need, very simple requirements, prove that you completed at least high school. We need to see your test scores, so the required, you know, language proficiency. You can use, again, Michigan test or Cambridge test. We need to see financial documents showing that you have enough money to support yourself in the first year of study and passport. Once we receive these documents, we send you congratulations, welcome to Bunker Hill community email, and send you the admission package. So we work fast, we have a small admission team, and we support you in the admission journey. Next. And you know, we want to make sure that students can be connected, not only with us staff members, but with our students. We have an option, we have student ambassadors. And if you would like to ask them questions about their experience as international student in general or at Bunker Hill, you can chat with them. You can go to Bunker Hill website. On the left, you will see ambassadors link and you can chat with our student ambassadors or with me. I'm also listed as a Unibody ambassador as a staff member. And next, and my last slide will be how to stay in touch with us. You can email us at international@bhcc.edu. When you go to Bunker Hill website, you can chat with us. You can call and leave a voicemail. We will give you a call back if you cannot reach us because we are busy answering the questions, or you can take a virtual tour of our campus. So we hope that this is helpful to you and you will stay in touch with us. And this is the end of my presentation. And I hope that we will be able to answer questions coming from our audience, from our guests.
Ella. Stephen, thank you for your presentation. And Julie, thank you for introducing the Michigan language exams as well and sharing the exciting update with everyone. So this is a great time now for Q&A. And Ella, I do have to say, as you said, this is really a hidden gem path to higher education in the US. So dear students, participants, please use the Q&A for questions. And let's see what the first one is. First question is, are you planning to offer community college programs online or distance for foreign students? So how does that work during COVID and just in general ongoing after COVID as well?
I will go first. Bunker Hill, so we offer a lot of flexibility to our admitted students. If you are admitted to Bunker Hill as an international student, but you are not able to arrive or not comfortable yet to travel, you can take as many classes as you want online from home. So we have a very good selection of classes that students can complete online from their home country. For those of you, if you who would apply for admission and decide to travel to Boston, we will have about 50% of classes that are meeting on campus. You are required to have on-campus classes if you come to the United States per federal regulations. So we can support both groups on our campus, those who want to study and start the program from home, and those of you who would decide to travel to Boston.
Yes, for Broward College, we do have a fully online program. You do have to remain in your country, and it's only certain programs that are available fully online. If you are wanting to come to the United States under the F1 visa program, normally F1 visa students are required to take the majority of their classes on campus. So for example, at Broward College, you have to be a full-time student, which for us is 12 credits. 9 of those credits have to be in face-to-face on-campus classes, and then you can take the others online or what it's called remote learning. We do start, since the pandemic, have started what are called remote learning classes, where you're in front of your computer, but you have to be there for a live class. So if your class meets on Tuesdays at 10 a.m., you have to be in front of your computer at Tuesday at 10 a.m. For the professor and your other students. Versus a regular online class where you have to do work each week, but when you choose to do it is up to you. You can do it at 3 a.m. or midnight, whatever is good for you. So we have both options. Now the government has said due to the pandemic that they're actually flipping that a requirement. So instead of having the 9 credits on campus and only 3 online, if you wish, you only have to have 1 3 credit class on campus, and then the rest can be either remote learning or online. We do anticipate that by the fall of next year, fall 2022, that we'll go back to the regular procedure. Broward College does, just like Bunker Hill, anticipate having about 50% of their classes open for on-campus learning for the fall term that's coming up in August. We also admit 3 times a year, just like Bunker Hill. So fall, spring, which is January, and then summer, which is May.
Mm-hmm. And then we have a question around graduate programs. So could you clarify again on how community colleges fit into the learning journey ending with graduate studies? Is there any connection? How does it all fit together, if it does?
Well, graduate school, of course, and depending on the type of program that you want to go to, obviously you may want to go to a more prestigious graduate school. So that means you would necessarily need to go to a more prestigious college. And so again, if you didn't qualify to go to that school directly from high school, you can use that community college to boost your academic profile, your academic resume, in order to get into that better school, which will then help you to get into the graduate school of your choice. As I also mentioned, there are people who already have a bachelor's degree from their country, but maybe their English is not good enough to get into that program. And so that's where doing an ESL program at a community college can then help you get into the graduate school that you're looking for.
I think I absolutely support everything Stephen said. From my personal experience, we did have students who did join Bunker Hill Community College and then transfer directly into a master degree programs at another college here. The students decided to join us to build the confidence in the English language to make sure that they can write and express themselves freely, so they are competitive in the admission process. And for personal enrichment, trying to take additional courses in their field in United States So they have fresher, more recent, you know, experience from a US institution.
Great. And then can you provide more detail about scholarships, especially for international students? Mm-hmm. What sort of the range that's covered? Is there a full ride scholarship? And what are the requirements for scholarship?
It's always the question of the hour, scholarships, right? So for one of the things to remember is that you have to be aware of what a scholarship covers. So Broward College does not offer scholarships for incoming students. You do have to show that you can afford to be an F1 student by you or your sponsor showing a certain amount of money that is in the bank that you can pay for at least your first two terms, as well as your estimated living expenses for the first year. It's very similar to what the Bunker Hill slide showed. That is a requirement for any school to get your F1 visa when you're presenting your paperwork to the embassies in your country. However, once you become a student, then you can become eligible for scholarships as an existing student, as well as especially if you were able to join and become a member of the Honors College, you can become eligible for additional scholarships as well. The thing to remember about scholarships is scholarships are only as good as what they cover. So for example, in one of my slides, I showed you University of Miami, which is around $50,000 a year, private school. If they give you a scholarship for $30,000, that sounds great. And you can go brag to your friends, I got a $30,000 scholarship, woo! But you're still having to come up with $20,000 out of your pocket to pay for school. $20,000 is double the cost of what it is to come to Broward College, which is only $10,000 per year. So you have to weigh what it means to have a scholarship.
At Bunker Hill, we also do not offer scholarships for incoming international students. We have an extensive selection of merit-based scholarships. So for all of you who would join us, who would finish semester or two, earn certain number of credits and achieve certain GPA, so your grade average, you can apply for many of the scholarships that we do offer. Many of our partner institutions offer students transferring from community colleges scholarships. Yesterday, I just reviewed one of our private institutions, downtown Boston, offered our student $18,000 scholarship, but their tuition trip is triple of what our annual tuition is. So exactly, just make sure that you compare apple to apple and oranges to oranges. I also wanted to mention one aspect of what our community college offers to our students. And this always amazes me how much support our students can receive. Outside of scholarships, we have student emergency fund. You can apply for up to $1,000 per your career at our college for emergency funding. If you lose your cell phone, if you lose an expensive book, or if you have a flooding and your clothing got damaged, you can apply for this funding. We have food pantry on campus for students who struggle, who maybe, misbudgeted the finances for a month. You can use our food pantry on campus. During pandemic, we were mailing cards to the grocery store so you could go and do grocery shopping. We offer help with getting iPads, Chromebooks, internet connections. I think we have a textbook assistance program that you can order one expensive book per semester. So there are those invisible ways how we can try to help our students, maybe not exactly directly via scholarship, but there are ways how we can help you to offset the cost of living. And of course, you can apply for on-campus jobs as well.
Thank you. And Amira, as I was asking about age restrictions, I mean, minimums or maximums to be able to apply to community college and or scholarship in case that's a separate mm-hmm. category.
I will respond. So we ask at Bunker Hill that students are 17 at the time when you start your program of study. And there is no upper age limit. I think our oldest student is approaching 90. It's not an international student, but really community college, you will see such a diversity of learners, which makes our campuses so special.
At Broward College, we have no age restriction. So even if you are graduated from high school at age 15, as long as you have a graduate from high school, you're eligible mm-hmm. to attend our school.
Wonderful. And can you share a little bit more about the international student experience on campus. What would their typical day be like? Where are students from, and what should they be looking forward to as an international student specifically?
Well, one thing for certainly South Florida, especially the Miami area, is a very international place already, as is Boston. I went to school in the Boston area. So both cities are very international. Yes. And so you have not only students, but people who actually live full time mm-hmm. all over the world. You can usually find your favorite food in a restaurant. So whether it's Indian food, yes. food from Vietnam, Colombia, of course, Italian, et cetera, you can find just about any kind of food that you're interested in around the area. But of course, we have many students, and not only just our international students, but as I mentioned in our my presentation, over 150 different countries around the world are represented at Broward College. So there's always international festivals, international days. So there's usually a lot of activity, and we have a lot of opportunity for students to interact with one another, build friendships. And also, of course, those friendships can turn into great networking opportunities as you go on in your career.
So I want to second that too. I think students who are joining Bunker Hill might have similar experience. Boston itself being very international city with many ethnic and nationalities being represented. I think this is reflected on our campus. Many students did comment on it. And this was also my experience from the first day I came to Bunker Hill for an interview. I'm from Poland. And I just feel when you step in, you feel like you are surrounded by people from around the world. You don't feel one person only, you are one of many. And I think this is what students really welcome, that they come to our campus and they feel like they belong. So the sense of belonging is very important. Our number of international students is significant. So we had almost 800 international students because of coronavirus and travel restrictions and visas. Our number went down to 500, but this is still a very good and very good number of international students around. Students are very active and engaged on our campus. Students are proactively looking and securing jobs on campus. So we have many international students working and helping other international students across the campus and help them navigate it. Our office international center, we have dedicated staff members, international students advisor, helping you to navigate your academic difficulties, looking for job certifications, OPT recommendations. We host workshops about how and when to work. We have international cafe when students can gather together and exchange, you know, the tips how to survive. And we have also a special session for international students at the beginning, just so we can educate you about, you know, what you can and should not do as an international student, as the immigration rules are quite restrictive. So I think we provide many opportunities for our students. I always say it is up to every individual person really to be proactive and pursue these opportunities. Benefit from as many opportunities to meet, get involved, be selected, elected to student government. This all counts. This is enriching your resume and it will help you on your way.
Fantastic. We have a few more minutes, so please do post any questions you have as we are close to wrapping up. We have a question about English studies. Can you provide a little bit more information? Do you run courses around the CFR and offer any of the either Cambridge English or Michigan certifications on your campus? That's a question from an anonymous attendee.
We don't have that certification at Broward College. Again, we do have our ESL program, or English for Academic Purposes program, that does teach you how to be a student in English.
Mm-hmm. At Bunker Hill, we do not provide testing for Michigan or Cambridge, but we accept this course. We have our brand new baby on campus. It's our intensive English program. It is four levels of instruction in English, and this graduates of this program can be admitted as to the certificate or associate degree program. If needed, we still have kind of scaffolding. We have called English ELL program, English Language Learning classes. There are 6 credit classes that still help students who might need additional support and additional instruction to improve your English and once you start your academic program. So our intensive English program is quite short. We don't have such an extensive, you know, number of levels offered like some of the language schools in the area, but definitely we can assist and support any language learner who would like to join us and improve English so you feel confident to, you know, join Bunker Hill or any other college anywhere.
And let me ask about the current COVID framework, anything students should be aware of. You know, obviously it's a fluid situation, but as far as you know, currently, what's the framework that they should be considering?
I want to say, you know, Boston and Massachusetts, we are in very fortunate situation. Our rate of immunizations, when you ask, it's very high. 70% of all adults have received immunization, and COVID shots are available at no cost to anyone who wants to receive it. We also have COVID clinics on our campus and in the community. So this is not a problem. I think in general, it is a safe place to be. The infection rate is very low. So we dropped the mask requirement outside of, you have to have it on the train in a medical establishment. And I forgot there was another, K-12, so between kindergarten and high schools. At Bunker Hill, we will drop the mask requirement as of the fall semester. I feel safe going to do grocery shopping. Life came back to normal. Restaurants, movie theaters, shopping centers are open, and there are people everywhere. So people are going back to enjoying their life. And I think for everyone who wants to travel, just make sure that you check with airline what requirement you need to meet, so arrive safely.
Yeah, we've had some students who've had difficulty getting their F1 visa and being able to travel to the United States. We do have in place already, even before the pandemic, that if for any reason you were not able to complete your application process, your application just automatically rolls over to the next term. So for students who are unable to arrive in the United States in time for the fall term, for example, then we would just roll them over to the spring term that starts in January. We would issue the new I-20 for them, or if they're not able to get their visa appointment, because some of the embassies are still closing down due to the pandemic. So the same thing there. So we do work with the students just to make sure that you're able to get your visa appointment and then match you up with the appropriate program once you get your visa.
The same here at Bunker Hill. We work tirelessly with everyone who has difficulty of visa delays to make sure that you can eventually get here. Will it be for the fall semester or hopefully for the spring as well? So be patient. You will get here.
Yeah. And Pete, I did see one question in the chat that I'll answer. A student had asked about high school. So yes, you do have to complete high school in order to be admitted to community college. We also accept the GED. So if you are not able to finish high school or the high school requirements in your particular country, you can sit for the GED if that's available to you in your country or online, or if you're able to come to the United States under a tourist visa and take the GED exam. As far as what considers high school, for most countries, it's simply showing your high school diploma. You scan that document, and then once you arrive in the United States, you have to show us the original. If you're from the British system, however, then it would be your test scores. So whether it would be the GRE or the BGCSE if you're in the Bahamas, or the CXEs if you're in the Caribbean. So we won't even look at your high school diploma. We look at your test scores for those tests.
Fantastic. I think that right about wraps up the Q&A today. Thanks everyone for joining us today and for your great questions. Excellent questions. And a big thank you to all of our presenters. Thank you, Julie, Ella, and Stephen for joining us today for a very, very insightful presentation, certainly uncovering a hidden gem here. So please do consider this wonderful option towards higher education in North America. We will provide useful links in the follow-up email, along with a link to the webinar recording. So you're going to be able to go back and check the links and some of the slides that are provided. Please keep an eye on our events page for news on our next webinar for learners. And we will be continuing that in the fall of this year. So with that, we wish you all the best on your learning journey and stay safe.
Thanks for having us. Take care.
Thank you
so much. Take care.
Everyone.